Welcome to a new video from EU Droneport. As we edge closer to 2024, big changes are on the horizon for drone regulations in Europe. In this video, we'll analyze some of the most important changes that operators of drones should be aware of. There's a bit of a challenge, though. While new rules are coming into play, many national regulations in different member states haven't quite caught up yet. This mismatch makes it tough for operators to figure out the day-to-day do's and don'ts. As we gear up for standardized, certified drone use and scenarios all across Europe, it's high time for EU member states to roll out new national rules that sync up with these changes. Here's the thing, each member state is responsible for managing its airspace and laying down the rules for flying in different areas. For example, some might want drone operators to give a heads up to the local law enforcement before taking off, especially when flying in urban areas. The big news here is the introduction of a mandatory date for using certified drones labeled with specific classes, allowing them to operate in the open category and European STS. It took several years after the inception of EU regulations before we started seeing certified drones hitting the market. Now there are already some available for purchase, which eases this transitional phase and propels further advancements in the UAS industry. If you're curious about which drones are certified as of today, you can find an updated list on our List of Certified Drones page. Click on the link in the description. For more insights into the drone certification process, you can visit our drone certification page. Click on the link in the description. These drones earn certification based on specific requirements tailored to the risks associated with each subcategory within the open category. For instance, drones with class marking C0 and C1 are suitable for flying in subcategory A1. They come with unique features that enhance safety in case of a fall, making it simpler for pilots to operate without requiring as many safety measures. Now let's talk about non-certified drones and what limitations they'll face in terms of usage. Here's the breakdown. Drones with a takeoff weight of less than 250 grams must be used in open category A1. Drones with a takeoff weight of less than 25 kilograms must be used in open category A3. These restrictions clearly indicate limitations on their usage. However, what if there's a need to operate these aircraft in a specific category? In such cases, options like conducting a specific operations risk assessment or obtaining operational authorization are available. Moreover, in certain countries, sticking to national standard scenarios is still a viable option. By doing so before the year concludes, it's possible to continue using these drones until the end of 2025, albeit in compliance with the regulatory standards. For more detailed information about flying in STS, standard scenarios, with non-certified drones, you can check out our article about flying in STS with non-certified drones. Check out the link in the description. As class-marked drones make their debut, European STS scenarios will become operational. These scenarios pave the way for flying across Europe, provided we meet the specific scenario prerequisites and have a drone equipped with class marking C5 or C6, corresponding to STS-01 and STS-02 scenarios, respectively. It's time to start preparing manuals to comply with the requirements of STS scenarios. Training for drones in the open category will remain the same in all member states since it was already standardized. For pilot training in the specific category, a unique training session must be completed, enabling flight in standard scenarios across all EU member states. Currently, many countries have training based on national scenarios, which must be adapted to the training requirements of European STS scenarios. In conclusion, a time of change is coming in the drone sector. Alongside the introduction of European regulations and their flight categories some years ago, this new stage will mark another significant change in the drone industry. For more information regarding Drone Regulation 2024, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.